How about grass? Capiz is also the site of the famous Santa Monica Church. It is part of the church, which is considered as the home to the largest Catholic church bell. It's Capiz. Moving on, we have the province of Guimaras. This is an island province. It's a little one, of course, in Iloilo, with 5 municipalities, the capital, which is the municipality. It's located just within Panay Gulf, between Panay Island and Negros Island. Okay. Okay. Probably next is probably one of the more famous province in Western Visayas, Iloilo. Capital is the important city Iloilo City. This is a quite expansive province with around 42 municipalities and 2 cities. It occupies majority of the southeast portion of the Visayan, Panay Island, and of course bordered by Ike, Capiz, Iloilo Strait, Panay Island. There's much to see in this province. And Iloilo is said to be one of the most preserved heritage destination in the present. A lot of sites, houses, particularly in City Hall. The next one is the province of Negros.
Negros is an
empire that has 19 municipalities with 13 cities. Napakadami. So it occupies half or the other half of the city of the larger Negros Island. It borders Negros Oriental, which comprises the other half. Negros Occidental is the sugar bowl in the Philippines. It produces more than half the sugar cane. And of course, we have the highly urbanized city of Iloilo, which is a conglomeration or mga pinagsama-sama ito ng mga former towns of the province of Iloilo, which includes, of course, the proper half, before half was an independent city. La Paz, Mandurriao. So, nowadays, isang city na isang region na city. So, Iloilo City was the last capital of the Spanish Empire in Asia and Pacific before Philippines was ceded to the United States. Kaya very prominent at very significant pa din ang Spanish cultures, Spanish influence, particularly architecture in Iloilo. And of course, the last is the city of Bacolod, geographically located in Negros Occidental, which is notable, very notable for the Mascara Festival, no, held during October. And relatively known to be a friendly city, kaya ang nickname din ito is the City of Smiles. Hindi ako masyadong magaling mo ito. Okay, so City of Bacolod has been awarded or has been recognized as one of the best places to live in the Philippines. It is also one of the center of excellence for business processes operations in the country and one of the top model cities. True enough naman, Bacolod City is a really nice and a very progressive city in not only in Negros Occidental, but to be full country. Right? So those are the administrative divisions of Western Visayas. Okay. Now in terms of transportation, as Western Visayas is a an island region composed of island provinces. Dominantly, the mode of transportation getting in into Western Visayas is by air. Of course, there are ships also or vessels serving the region by sea. But of course, the quickest, the fastest way to get in is by air. So, Iloilo City is the main transport hub and actually the largest city in the region. That's why it's the main transport hub. It has an airport and domestic flights, and for some international flights, then Iloilo City also is your jump off to other parts of the region by ferry and to other more distant places like Palawan. Of course, we have Iloilo International Airport in there. Now for Aklan, we have Calibo International Airport in Vamos Airport in Aklan. And we also have Rojas Airport in Capiz, and the San Jose Airport or Antique Airport or the Velio Javier Airport in Antique, of course, and the Bacolod Silang Airport in Negros. So there are a lot of ways to get into the region. You actually, even if Iloilo is the main transport hub, you can actually bypass Iloilo if you want to go to other parts of the region. Well, of course, for Guimaras, because your direct connection to Guimaras is via Iloilo. Now, in terms of cuisine, highly organized and structured ang culinary profile na Western Visayas. You can easily identify a certain cuisine that is attributed to the region. Of course, we have topping our list, we have Malapas Bachoy in Iloilo. It's one of the best known signature dishes, and whenever you go there, it's like you haven't went to Iloilo if you haven't tasted this one. This is of course in Iloilo. Lapas Bachoy, because it, according to history notes, it originated from Lapas Market. Then we have the Pancit Mono, which is technically not really a pancit. A standout among the pancit because of its non-traditional pancit look. So it's a derivative of the Chinese food, of course. Like when you will be served with pancit, one of the first thing that you're gonna ask is that where's the pancit? But they explained that the actual pancit is actually the molo wrappers, which is basically of the same mixture when creating or producing. And of course, we have chicken inasal of Negros. It's an ilonggo term, of course, which means charred grill. So this is a derivative of a roasted meat. So it's very well known, very popular on the province that even have a market strip. That's the Mangutan country, where all the menus have inasal as their star. And we also have barangay. Dish naman of Aklan. This is just a simple recipe that is chicken, simmered in spices, but the thing that you can do is maybe shot of banana. Banana chunk. Inubara basically means the dish. Wrapped in banana. So, in the native language or native dialects, it means para. So, literally, it's binano. And of course, we have the sequence. Well, most parts of the Philippines, particularly mga island provinces, islands have seafoods, but it's kahis that attributed as the seafood character of the Philippines. Those grade by beach, so si Senyo for seafood dining, the shore, the park, seafood port, facing Cebuyan Sea, where you can eat, you can fish. For other sibo or other trees, they have sponge, yaya, and famous mango infused dishes. So very famous stuff. As you know, they have mango pizza, liver pasta, mango, bonus mango. Almost all of their dishes has mango infused. For top destinations, of course, no question about it, we have Aklanon. But a little bit more specific, in my mind, the majority or that is receiving a huge number of visitors. Although Calibo is the gateway for international flights direct to Boracay, pero paglapag din naman ng guests sa Calibo, they are transported straight to Malay. So, again, there is no chance other municipalities gain from another benefit tourism or huge July products. Like siya concentrated here. Then of course we have Iloilo province and the city of Iloilo. And Negros Occidental, and of course the city of Iloilo. Okay, so let's move on to the top attractions. Right? Let's start with the province of Aklan. Of course, without questions about it, the topic that is in the Boracay Island, which is the tourism jewel of Aklan and of the whole country, awarded for so many times as the best island in the world. By big names, by big magazines, Condenas, Travel Fest, and others. So let's focus on the other attractions of Aklan. Now, if you want to have a panoramic view of the island, Boracay Island, so the best place to go is Mawang. So, hindi lahat na nagpunta sa Boracay is aware that there's this very nice view deck where you can see the whole stretch of Boracay Island, the beach of Boracay. This is mountain. So, this is mountain in Boracay. Again, with an observation deck, very sweeping view of the islands and the ocean. Okay, so you may take a 15-minute hike uphill to Mount Lugo. It is the highest point in Boracay. So, you may hire an ATV or try to get it to find it. Aklan, I feel view deck. Now, Aklan also has a wind farm. So this is an array of 25 gigantic wind turbines aligned up along the mountain ridge. So, but if you wanna get close to it, it's kind of steep ang ascent. Pero you can ride a motorcycle and get close to it. Although the wind farm is in Nabas, so this is Nabas wind farm, it's still closer to Katiklan than to the town proper of Nabas. So from Katiklan, it's just a 15 or 20 minute tricycle ride junction that will lead you to the wind farm. So pwede rin habal-habal if you want to go straight to the wind farm. Okay, another notable destination is Ariel's Point or the Batason Point. Okay, it should not be missed as well when you visit Aklan. Okay, it has a limestone cliff surrounded by lush green. So, the signature thing being done here in Ariel's Point is the cliff diving. So, if you are daring enough, then you can dive from different levels of the diving planks or platforms on the limestone cliff, then straight to the deep sea water. So, kung hindi naman kayang mag-cliff dive, then you may use kayaking, stand-up paddling around the waters. Then we have Bakhawan Eco Park. This is in Calibo. So if you fly to Aklan via, if you want to go to Rakay, if you want to add spice, trip to the island, then might still fly to Calibo, then from there on, pass to other destinations all the way to Rakay. And one is Bakhawan Eco Park, which is also one of the most popular spots here in the province. Recommended for tourists who want to leisurely immerse with nature. This is a very expansive area, a lot of mangroves. The good thing here is there is an established boardwalk, which is made from wood and bamboo. It was built around the mangrove forest, rather, where you can just admire. Then we have Hacienda Maria. This is also an unspoiled beauty of nature, as they say. It's an ecotourism destination in the province. It's also frequented by most foreign tourists. It includes the whole area includes waterfalls, there are caves. There's this hot pot jacuzzi or what we call the kawa bath, so they can also enjoy swimming, cliff jumping from the waterfalls. So it's like a one-stop shop ecotourism destination in the province of Hacienda Maria. Okay, Motag Living Museum. So this is very near Cataclan Airport. Motag Living Museum is an interactive cultural expo that showcases traditional farming methods, weaving traditional crafts, cooking the lights, sharing mga folk songs ng mga tagamalay. So, 20-30 minutes away from Cataclan lang to, so siguro if you fly indirectly to Cataclan, go to Boracay, maybe you can do side trip before going there or just before your flight back. Like, this is very nice. I have been to Motag, and it's very immersive talaga. There are a lot of foreigners also going in here. Yeah, so those are just some of the... I came from a rural area, but still, it's fun for me to see attractions like this. Riding a caravan sa Malika. Okay, Basura Garden. Tayo sa Manatasa Aklan, Malete. This is an unusual garden, unusual destination for matter. So the name of this place is of course derived from the collection of artifacts and cultures. Take mga recycled garbage materials from the natives of Malete and other parts of the land. So they transform this recycled materials arts. So, parang siya mga art installation. So, it's really a mall of art that exhibits craftsmanship. Okay, if you want to learn more about the history, the rich history, heritage, and graphics, may head to the Academy, which is located at the heart of Kinaray-a. It has a heritage structure. It's located in an 18th century building with a very nice structure as well. Then, Then we have the Calibo Cathedral. So this is the same cathedral where the image of Santo Niño is enshrined, yung patron ng Ati-Atihan Festival. As a reminder of the past, its past, this church, the old massive church beds are still displayed right in front of the cathedral. It's Calibo. Now moving on to our next province, the province of Antique. Let's watch this one. so those are some few spots on province of Antique. So that video is one of the credit to the office of Honorable Lauren Ligarda. Sa kanila ko nakuha yung video na yan. Okay, so let's have the attractions of province of Antique. Antique, a little trivia muna about the province. It's one of the provinces of the Philippines that is famous for its mythical folk stories and unspoiled tourist spots, of course, along with other provinces of Sikihor. Perhaps the rumors of the presence of these strange mythical creatures is one of the reasons kung bakit out of curiosity ay pumupunta ang mga tourists to explore the province of Antique. However, there are of course much known tourist spots where particularly in the coastal areas that are blessed with sand, islands, sandbars. And in addition to that, the province of Antique made popular the Kawa Hot Bath. So, kung may mga nakakita kayong Kawa Hot Bath in other parts of the Philippines nowadays, now it's probably because of Antique. So, let's start with the Antique Rice Terraces in San Remo. Okay, so this is a recent discovery, but it's already considered as a cultural treasure in the province. Okay, and really, you wouldn't thought, as the pitch ko doon, you wouldn't thought that there's a cluster of rice terraces here, because when we say rice terraces, they're all geared to Cordillera. But of course, there's one existing in here. Okay. Again, as I mentioned earlier, this is made by or built by the Iloilo City indigenous group. So, as this has been relatively a visited destination, so the local government have already made a viewing area that can give you a breathtaking scenery of the rice terraces. However, if you want to get close to the rice terraces, it's really challenging. So, of course, I didn't do that in sa view deck. Kasi roughly sabi ng office, roughly it will take you 5 hours to do a trek just to reach the rice terraces. I'd rather stay in the viewing. Okay, next, Mararison Island or Malalison Island. This is probably one of the most notable spots here. Best spot here in Antique. It's an expansive island of rolling hills with grasses, stretches of white sand beach, pebble beaches. So, one of the notable part here in Mararison Island is the shifting sandbar. It's surrounded, of course, with waters with very nice marine life that are best for swimming and swimming. Then we also have another famous island here in Antique, Ibiao particularly. That's the second island. It's one of the most beautiful islands in the province. It's of course quite known also in the entire country. It's a flat elbow shape, kaya nga tinawag na second. Aside from the trees, the white sand, there's really nothing more to see in the island, but it's really a perfect place. You want to get away from the crowd. Another notable island, Nogas Island. Okay, it's also an expansive area, island covered with lush greenery. There's also white sand here, but one of the best part here is the one you're seeing in your screen right now, that array of trees. It's one of the most picturesque spots here. Of course, Rafflesia. What's Antique without seeing Rafflesia? Okay, so also in San Remo, where the rice terraces is mentioned. Okay, so Rafflesia is literally a blooming and a booming attraction in the province. Aside from the rice terraces and the waterfalls there in San Remo. So Rafflesia have caught the attention of the public, social media. It actually a rediscovered attraction in that it's really making a mess. Russia, of course, is the biggest power in the world, which is endemic to Southeast Asia, including the Philippines. According to my research, 10 of 27 species of Russia can be found here. Alam naman natin siguro yung smell niya na no, nababasa. It's not really. Okay. Now, the municipality of Tibiao is one of the greater one of the destined for municipalities here that receives huge number of tourists. So, with a lot of attractions that can receive Tibiao. That includes also Tibiao Weaver, which is geared for marketed as an eco-adventure destination. It's very much accessible from land. The Biao River is said to be one of the best white water rivers in the country, which is perfect for kayaking. Then we also have the Biao Museum. This is a very interesting museum. It highlights the pearls of the Biao. Okay, if you have heard or if you know the world's biggest pearls, they are in Tibiao. This is already an important cultural property which is rendered here in the National Museum. And according to some notes, according to some write-ups, the pearls are said to cost roughly $100 million as assessed by the National Museum. So very nice. Now, if you're looking for an extraordinary dining experience in Antique, there's this hyper-local restaurant that's